What up, what up? Wimbush here. And today I wanted to address something that I caught during the Tim Sweeney talk that Immature Gamer actually posted to his Twitter feed. I'll leave a link down below if you want to watch the full thing in its entirety, because it's about 10 minutes long. And there's a little nugget in there that even I missed. My friend Logan actually brought it to my attention. If you move forward to about 5 to 6 minutes in, he starts talking about the plans for Unreal Engine moving into 2024. I'll play the clip and then I'll get my thoughts afterwards.
And so, you know, our game developer business model, we think, is really sound. It's a business model designed so that we succeed and you succeed. And most teams, you know, at paying any royalty at all, but, you know, ultimately, I think everybody comes to look at it as, like, we're all professional developers here. And the Unreal Engine team, if you're using Unreal Engine, it's kind of an extension of your team. And if you weren't paying us money for the engine, you'd have to hire really awesome people to build your own, and you'd be paying them too. And, you know, these would have costs for your business. Yeah, we think our structure for game developers is really sound. There has been a quirk of our engine business for a while that we're going to patch next year, and that's that we have an engine that's completely free for anybody to use, but if you're never shipping a product that's royalty bearing, then you never pay any money at all. And this doesn't affect game developers, but one of the things we're going to change next year is for industries other than game development, you know, such as automotive industry and so on, we're going to move to a seat-based enterprise software licensing model for Unreal Engine. And we don't have terms to announce yet, but this is just, I wanted to get this out in front of everybody for transparency. We're going to move to a model like that. It's not going to be unusually expensive or unusually inexpensive, but if you're going to be building a product outside the game industry and not paying a royalty on it, then yeah, it'll be a licensable piece of software like Maya or Photoshop or whatever. That will just be a change that tries to bring our engine revenue back and associated with the teams that are doing the work in the industries. A funny thing about being funded so heavily by Fortnite over the past 6 years is we've kind of let different parts of our business get disconnected from their revenue streams. Yeah, we have big teams serving different industry verticals, building this and that set of features for custom clients without revenue to support it. And that's been fine because we've seen adoption grow massively. But one of the rigors that we need to do as we become a lower margin company and kind of have to cope with this is reassociating revenue streams with the things we're doing.
It sounds like they're going to be charging maybe a subscription fee for Unreal Engine in 2024. They don't know exactly what this is going to look like, so there's no need to panic yet. But he did address that, you know, the gaming industry, whenever they use Unreal Engine, they pay a royalty to it whenever they ship the product and it makes $1 million of revenue. But for anybody else, that's particularly not fair that we don't have to pay anything whenever we ship a product, which, you know, off the top, that's kind of what they told us in the first place. But I get it, you're running a company, you have to make revenue somewhere in there. And so they're trying to talk about how they might be able to make some money on the back end on projects that are other than gaming. He did mention in there, he called out Maya and Photoshop. So that's why I think subscription-based, because he said we might follow that type of model there. But there might be some hope there because, you know, a lot of subscriptions, they also have like an indie license, they have a pro license, you know, so there might be some type of tier structure in there. Of course, like I said, he didn't say exactly what they're going to be charging or how they're going to be charging it, but he just wanted to jump in front of it because this is something that they're thinking about for 2024. So leave me a comment down below. Let me know what you're thinking. Maybe I'm looking too much into this, but to me, it sounds like we're going to have to pay for Unreal moving here in the future, which I have no problem with. I was kind of expecting this earlier, to be honest with you. Like, I can't believe they went on this long without charging anybody else but the gaming industry. Myself, as a professional motion graphics artist, I've used Unreal Engine on a lot of different projects. And so I pay for, you know, the Adobe subscription, the Maxon One subscription. Like, I don't mind paying for my software because I make the money back when I'm working on these projects. But I know a lot of you guys out there are probably even hobbyists or maybe independent developers that you're not making money on the back end of this stuff. So I can see how it's going to hit some of you guys. So definitely let me know down below what you're thinking, or maybe I'm just looking too much into this. But make sure you subscribe for more Unreal Engine tutorials moving here in the future, because as I said, I'm going to keep using it. So until next time, stay fresh, keep creating, and I catch you in the next video. I'll see you soon. Take care.